All right, here it is. This is the helmet that I use for all my video making. This is the Bell Qualifier DLX. I wanted to have something that's nice and streamlined, and I thought that this would fit the bill pretty easily because I could have this with, you know, music piped into my headset inside the helmet. And I could also have, you know, my chin mount GoPro on here. And that was another big reason why I chose this helmet, was because the chin area of this helmet right here is flat. As you notice, there's no vents or anything down below this line right here. So this gave me a good opportunity to mount my GoPro unit right to the chin of my helmet. Now, I know you can buy different GoPro mounts and things and hang them off the side over here and have them running to the front with brackets and things like that. And then you can have your GoPro there, but I didn't want all that stuff hanging off the side of my helmet. I'm just not a big fan of, you know, cluttery looking helmets and a whole bunch of things creating a bunch of wind noise. The key to getting a nice clean installation like this is using a product called Sugru. Now I'm going to put the helmet away. You can see basically how the GoPro mount is mounted there. Show it to you from the side here real quick. If you can see down inside there, that black stuff that's between the GoPro mount and the helmet itself is called Sugru. I'm going to put the helmet away and I'll show you this product right now. All right, so this is a product called Sugru. It's a moldable, kind of a putty sort of glue. You can buy this stuff on Amazon or pretty much anywhere that you can, buy this on Amazon or pretty much anywhere that you can find products like this. eBay probably has it, but I got mine off of Amazon. It's kind of spendy. I think this was $20 for 8 of these little tiny packages. I think they're pretty much single-use packages. When you open the box, let me get this open, they come in these little things like this. And they're basically silly putty. And what you do is you take these things and whatever you want to stick whatever to, you mold it just like silly putty and you can kind of contour it to whatever shape that you're looking to put it on. So basically I took this and stuff and I put it on the back of my GoPro mount that I was going to put on my helmet, and then I squished it up to the helmet. And then what I did, basically I took a razor blade and cut the excess off, and then I let this stuff sit for, it calls for 24 hours cure time. So you want to just let it sit for 24 hours. And then once you're done, you basically, you're good to go. This stuff is stuck solid, very solid. However, when you're mounting your GoPro mount to the front of your helmet, make sure you set it on a flat surface and stand back from it and look at it. You know, put your GoPro in the mount while you're doing it and make sure everything's nice and lined up and flat, because you don't want this stuff to dry up and then you mount your helmet cam on your helmet and then come to find out that it's way off kilter. It's not centered, you know, and you're riding around having to keep your head tilted or your video footage is just going to look like crap. So really take your time with this stuff. Like I said, you have 24 hours for this stuff to dry, but I think it's got a little bit of time you have to work with it before it starts to. Yeah, it says here you have 3 minutes to move, fix, build, and create basically your mold, whatever you're gluing to, whatever you're molding to. So this stuff is pretty awesome. That's the key to getting a nice, clean GoPro mount to your helmet. All right, now back to the helmet itself. You see the mount, how I have it on there. So now let's talk about basically what I use to record my videos. What I use, I'll put the helmet away. Actually, let me demonstrate here basically what the helmet looks like with the GoPro mounted to it real quick. So, as you can see, that's basically, let me twist this so the light's not shining in it. That's what the helmet looks like with the GoPro mounted to it. As you can see, it's a very clean installation. Very, very clean. What I've used for my helmet mount right here, as you can see that angled bracket, it's a curvy bracket. This comes in basically a kit that you can buy on Amazon. It's like a 200-piece kit or something like that, some cheap kit from China. And it comes with all kinds of different brackets that you can use on your GoPro. So here's my GoPro. I want to show you the bracket on the back right here, because like I said, it's from a cheap Chinese kit. Now if you can look right here, you can see in this area right here where I've sanded some of this out with a Dremel. Problem with it was, when I first mounted it on there, it would only close to, I want to say right about there. And the problem that what that was is when I'd ride around with it mounted to my helmet like that before I sanded it, the footage was too low, you know, staring too low at the ground. So I had to take my Dremel and just sand some of that stuff out of there. That way, when you fold it back like this, it damn near touches the screen of the GoPro. So that's what gives me the perfect angle for basically my videos. And I'm not saying that my videos are the best, but I put a lot of work into this stuff. With the Hero 7 Black, this is my primary camera. I used to run the Hero 5 Black, which is right here, which is also a good camera, don't get me wrong, but the Hero 7 Black, the color quality and the image stabilization of it is just so much better than this 5. I still do use this 5 for like B-cam shots and like when I'm doing writing videos and I wanted to have a camera pointed at me while I'm talking and stuff. This is the one that I use for that, but the Hero 7 Black just produces way better color science and better stability, like I said. So now if you're coming here wondering how to set up your audio for moto vlogging, I have a suggestion. These guys right here, you have to buy one of these things, plug a microphone into either one of these cameras. The problem with these things is everybody has problems with them. Every once in a while you won't capture any audio, and if you go out riding around and you record what you thought was an hour's worth of footage, you get back to your house and all of a sudden it's not there. You know, so your vlog is ruined, your video is ruined. So what I'm going to suggest that you do with this thing right here is just take and get rid of it. Don't run it. Those things are way too problematic, which is too bad because I really, really do like GoPro products. I'm a big fan of their cameras. I never use mine. I've used it two or three times and had audio problems with it. And I don't know exactly what causes the problem. I think it's something to do with the quick start feature that you have on your GoPro. I think you can have a workaround if you basically just make sure that the camera is powered on every time before you hit record, and then you shouldn't have any problems with your audio. I'm just not willing to risk it because I put a lot of work into my videos and it takes me an hour and a half to film these things, and it probably takes me 5, 6, 7, 8 hours to edit them. So I'm not taking a risk on it. So my suggestion is you go out and buy a digital voice recorder. This little guy right here. This is the Sony ICD-UX560. If you look back early in my channel, I started with this voice recorder and then I moved to this voice recorder. So you can hear my earlier videos where the audio wasn't all that great. But moving on to this one and changing some settings inside of the voice recorder has really improved my audio, and now I'm at a happy place with it. One thing though that I should, you know, make a note of right here, in order to plug in a lot of these cables, these microphone cables, these come with what's called a TRRS. The TRRS, sometimes you won't be able to plug this into a voice recorder. So what you need to run is just basically go out and buy one of these. And all this is basically, it's an adapter and it changes basically a 3-ring input to a 2-ring input. I'll show you side by side right here. You can see there, a 3-ring and a 2-ring. Some voice recorders you can't plug a 3-ring into. They won't work. So I switched anyways, get back to this other voice recorder. Its form factor is much nicer and portable for recording videos. This one right here, as you can see, the microphone input comes out of the top, which means I can drop this down into a pocket and not have to worry about messing up the audio input in any way. But anyways, you'll need one of these adapters with a lot of microphones. So let's get back to the microphone that I have running in my helmet and I'll show you how that's set up. All right, here we are back at the helmet. I'm just going to go over this real quick because there's no real easy way of explaining this. When you mount your helmet or your microphone inside your helmet, you're going to want to find a nice quiet place to put it. This right here, this microphone that I run is called the Purple Panda. I found this one also on Amazon. Based on the reviews, I bought it. It's a little bit more spendy than your average little cheap lapel microphone, but it's worth the money. I mean, it sounds really nice. Basically, I have this Purple Panda microphone. It's shoved inside the cheek pad right here. See if I can show that to you. Get a good angle on that. It is shoved inside the cheek pad. The wires are going up through the bottom here, and then it kind of loops around inside the helmet. And then the microphone comes out right here. Now, I'm not going to take it out of there, but the microphone is tucked in behind the cheek pad, and then it has a little foam thing on it. One of these guys. And then on top of the foam, I also have one of these, which you can order these off of Amazon. This is just basically a dead cat for a shotgun microphone, and you can take the top part of it and cut it off and then wrap your foam part of your microphone and your lapel microphone inside this thing and then tuck it back in behind the cheek pad right here. And by going through all this different experimentation and everything, this is how I kind of came up with a combination of this microphone, the GoPro Hero 7 Black, and my digital voice recorder is basically how I came up with good audio for my Motovlogs. And I'm happy with it right now. So I hope nothing breaks and nothing changes and I have to go and redo all this crap. But anyways, I know this video has run pretty long. But I hope this helps anybody who had questions on basically my my helmet setup, my Motovlog setup, how my audio is set up. I can do another video later on if you want me to, explaining the settings in this little voice recorder right here to get it to produce the best quality sound. If you want something like that, just leave a request down in the comments down below and I can make a video, a short quick video explaining the what settings you want to use. But anyways, I know this video has gotten pretty long and I'm sorry for keeping you this long, but if you're still around, thank you for watching. And once again, I want to say thank you to now the over 7,100 subscribers that I have on my channel. It's just incredible. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you for watching. Ride safe, have a good day, and we'll catch you on the next video.